Corporation Bill. Our efforts were to avail the National Assembly with sufficient time to perform its important duty of passing the appropriation bill into law, hopefully by the 1st of January 2018. It is in this spirit that I solicit the cooperation of the legislature in our efforts to return to a more predictable budget cycle that runs from January to December. The 2014-18 budget proposal for the budget of consolidation. Our principal objective will be to reinforce and build our recent accomplishments. Specifically, we will sustain the reflationary policies of our first two budgets. In this regard, the key parameters and assumptions for the 2018 budget are as set out in the 2018 to 2020 medium-term expenditure framework and fiscal strategy paper. These include benchmark oil price of $45 per barrel, oil production estimate of 2.3 million barrels per day, including condensate, C, exchange rate of 305 naira to United States dollar for 2018, D, real GDP growth of 3.5%, and E, inflation rate of 12.4%. Based on the above fiscal assumptions and parameters, total federally collectible revenue is estimated at 11.98 trillion naira in 2018, such that the three tiers of government shall receive about 12% more revenue in 2018 than the 2017 estimate. Of the amount, the sum of 6.387 trillion naira is expected to be realized from oil and gas sources. Total receipts from the non-oil sector are projected at 5.597 trillion naira. The federal government's estimated total revenue is 6.607 trillion naira in 2018, which is about 30% more than the 2017 target. As we pursue our goal of revenue diversification, non-oil revenues will become a larger share of total revenues. In 2018, we project our oil revenue of 2.442 trillion naira and non-oil as well as other revenues of 4.165 trillion naira. Non-oil and other revenue resources of 4.165 trillion naira include several items, including share of companies' income tax of several hundred and 947 billion naira, share of value-added tax of 207.9 billion naira, customs and excise receipts of 324.9 billion naira, federal government independent generated revenue of 847.9 billion naira. Federal government share of tax amnesty income of 87.8 billion naira and various recoveries of 512.4 billion naira, 710 billion naira as proceeds from the restructuring of government equity in joint ventures and other sundry income of 678.4 billion naira. A total expenditure of 8.612 trillion naira is proposed for 2018. This is a nominal increase of 16% above the 2017 budget estimate. In keeping with our policy, 30.8% of 2.652 trillion naira of aggregate expenditure, inclusive of capital statutory transfers, has been allocated to the capital project. We expect our fiscal operations to result in a deficit of 2.005 trillion naira, or 1.77% of GDP. This reduction is in line with our plans under Economic Recovery and Growth Plan to progressively reduce deficit and borrowings. We plan to finance the deficit partly by new borrowing, estimated at 1.699 trillion naira. 50% of this borrowing will be sourced externally, while the balance will be sourced domestically. The balance of the deficit of 306 billion naira is to be financed from proceeds of privatization of some non-oil assets by the Bureau of Public Enterprises. The proposed 8.612 trillion naira of 2018 aggregate expenditure comprises a recurrent cost of 3.494 trillion naira, debt service of 2.014 trillion naira, C, statutory transfer of about 456 billion naira, D, sinking fund of 220 billion naira to retire maturing bond to local contractors, E, capital expenditure of 204.28 trillion naira, excluding the capital component of statutory transfer, 456.46 billion naira was provided in the 2018 budget for statutory transfer. The 5% increase over last year's provision is mainly due to increases in transfer to Niger Delta Development Commission and the Universal Basic Education Commission, which are related directly to the size of oil revenue. We are closely monitoring our debt service to revenue ratio. We shall address this ratio through our non-oil revenue generating drive and restructuring of the existing debt portfolio. Presently, domestic debt accounts for about 79% of the total debt. Our medium-term strategy is to reduce the proportion of our domestic debt to 60% by the end of 2019 and increase external debt to 40%. It is noteworthy that rebalancing our debt portfolio will enhance private sector access to domestic credit. In addition, annual debt service costs will reduce as external debts are serviced at lower rates and repaid over a longer period than domestic debt. A substantial part of the recurrent cost proposal for 2018 is the payment of salaries and overheads in key ministries providing critical public services such as 1, 510.87 billion naira.